Oh, I'm going to point it in a safe direction.
Oh, thank you.
So you have to take off all the gobbledygook that's on there. And we use the cage, actually, as a safety measure. By the way, my parents have a lovely dent in their kitchen floor here from a bottle of Prosecco I dropped while demonstrating how to open one without making a pop. There was no pop, but there was a drop,
kids.
And then it shot halfway across their kitchen floor in the stream of Prosecco, which I grabbed and put in the sink. But to this day, they still have that little memory there. So for safety purposes, what you do is you loosen the wire on the cage, and then you move it up one notch to the top and retighten it. So that way, just in case that cork decides it wants to jump out of there before you pop it with the big knife, it doesn't go. So there's our little safety cage.
Wow, that's good.
Next thing you have to do is find the seam of the bottle. This can be fun sometimes. Because you have to run it right up the seam. I'm not talking the seam of the label, but the seam of the bottle. There it is.
Is it getting warm?
No. So I found my seam. I'll pick that up later. It's a little bigger than that little knife I used to use to cut those mushrooms. Also, dull enough it cannot cut apart. It has a point, though. So what we do, and you can actually saber, and I'm not going to shoot you here. You can saber even with, like, a tablespoon. You just need something metal that's going to hit that edge and go. So a lot of build-up, and hopefully it will go. So I'm going to shoot in a safe direction. So what we do is we run up the seam to the top, and supposedly when it clinks on that, it's going to shoot the cork out of there with a little spray of sparkling. So, damn, it worked! And you could seriously injure someone or yourself with that, so you have to be careful there. But there we are.
Good man, Jack.
Ha ha ha.